Oh, is it hot out here? Mia and I traveled out to the desert to search for fossils, but so far we found nothing but sand, rocks, and an extreme need for sunscreen. Wait a minute. What's this? Mia, I think we found our first fossil. Wait a minute, is this a seashell? I think the heat must be getting to me because that doesn't make any sense. Why would there be a fossil of a sea creature way out here in the desert? By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe how fossils are formed and explain what they can teach us about the Earth's past. Let's investigate. Have you ever been to a museum and seen giant dinosaur bones or ancient plants and animals trapped inside rock? They're super cool to look at. But have you ever stopped to wonder what exactly are fossils? And how do they form? Fossils are the preserved remains or traces of living things that lived a long, long time ago. Normally, when a plant or animal dies, its remains break down or decay. But in some special cases, those remains are protected and preserved, turning into fossils. Even though paleontologists, the scientists who study fossils, have uncovered tons of different fossils all over the world, the truth is, most living things never become fossils at all. Fossilization, or the process of becoming a fossil, is actually really rare. Only under the right conditions can a plant or animal be preserved for millions of years. So, how does that happen? Let's take a closer look. Most fossils are discovered inside sedimentary rock. Think about how sedimentary rock is formed. Based on that, how do you think fossils are created? Pause the video and record your prediction in your guided notes. Sedimentary rocks are formed when sediments, like sand and minerals, are deposited in layers and pressed together over time. This layering process is the key to fossilization. One type of fossil that forms this way is a body fossil, the preserved remains of hard body parts like bones, shells, and teeth. For a body fossil to form, a plant or animal needs to be buried by sediments super quickly before it has a chance to decay. This usually happens in places like rivers or oceans where sand and mud can quickly cover the remains. As more and more layers press down over time, the sediments turn into sedimentary rock, trapping the bones or shells inside. Water seeps into the rock, carrying with it tiny bits of different minerals. The minerals fill in all the teensy empty spaces in the remains. Over time, the mixture of minerals hardens, turning the bones or shells into stone. The body fossils paleontologists find are usually just small pieces of a living thing, like a woolly mammoth's tusk, a dinosaur's tooth, or just one lonely toe bone. Paleontologists have to piece these clues together like a puzzle, except without the picture on the box, and with most of the pieces missing. But not all fossils come from bones or teeth. Sometimes a fossil forms when just the shape of a living thing is left behind. These are called mold and cast fossils. A mold fossil forms when a plant or animal is buried in sediment, but instead of the hard parts turning into stone, they break down and disappear over time. This leaves an impression or an empty space in the shape of the living thing, kind of like a footprint in wet sand. A cast fossil forms when that mold fossil gets filled in with minerals. Think of an ice cube tray. When you pour water into the empty spaces and freeze it, the ice takes the shape of the tray. In the same way, minerals fill in the mold fossil and harden, creating a fossil that looks just like the original living thing. But instead of a cold drink, you're left with a fossilized seashell from millions of years ago. Slightly less refreshing, but still very cool. Not all fossils are formed from the actual remains of a living thing, though. Instead, some fossils preserve evidence of their activities. These are called trace fossils. Instead of bones or shells, trace fossils preserve things like footprints, burrows, and even nests. Trace fossils could teach us a lot about the living things from the past. Paleontologists have discovered tracks left behind by dinosaurs, showing how fast they ran, whether they traveled in groups, and even if they were hunting or being chased. Even coprolite, that's fossilized droppings, can help scientists learn what prehistoric animals ate. Try thinking like a paleontologist yourself. Here we have a body fossil, a mold fossil, and a trace fossil. Can you figure out which is which? Pay close attention to whether you're looking at body parts, an imprint, or evidence of activity. Pause the video and record your thoughts in your guided notes. Here we have a fossilized footprint. This is a trace fossil, which shows us evidence of this ancient creature's movements. Next is a bone. This is definitely a body fossil and part of the living thing that has been turned to stone over time. And finally, this mold fossil shows the shape of an ancient plant, even though none of the plant's parts are here anymore. No matter which type is uncovered, every fossil gives scientists a window into the past, helping them piece together what ancient living things were like. And sometimes those clues reveal something even bigger, not just about plants and animals, but about how the entire Earth has changed over time. Fossils act like a snapshot in time, which means they could teach us a lot about changes that have happened to the Earth. For instance, fossils can provide clues to how the Earth's climate has changed over time. Paleontologists have found fossils of tropical plants in places that are now freezing cold, like Antarctica. What do you think this could mean for what this area was like in the past? It was probably once much warmer and covered in lush forests instead of ice. Fossils also provide evidence for continental drift. Scientists have unearthed fossils of an extinct reptile called Mesosaurus in both South America and Africa. Since this reptile definitely couldn't swim across an entire ocean, these two continents were probably once joined together a long, long time ago. Paleontologists pieced together these clues to reconstruct what the world once looked like. We weren't there to see these changes happen, but fossils help us uncover Earth's ancient history. Scientists, we found a seashell in the middle of a dry desert. Unless we just stumbled upon the remains of a prehistoric souvenir shop, what could this mean about the area's past? While we ponder that, let's review everything we've learned today. Fossils are the preserved remains or traces of living things from long ago. Fossils can be formed in different ways. Body fossils preserve hard parts like bones and shells. Mold and cast fossils capture the shape of a living thing. And trace fossils preserve evidence of activity. Fossils also provide clues as to how Earth has changed over time. To learn more about fossils, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions that go with this lesson. So, what do you think this seashell could be telling us about this desert's past? I think this place might have once been underwater. Maybe it was even a whole ocean. Yeah, let's go try and find more fossils to see if we can piece together what this place used to look like. Keep exploring, scientists. There's always more to discover beneath the surface. See you next time! Hey, hey.